developing that airport. He's developing it, he jointly owned, and you know, continue to build it to an international standard level. So there were three agreements that were signed. One of them is a shareholders agreement, meaning you are partners together in that airport. Rwanda is 40% in terms of the shareholding, and Qatar is 60% in terms of the shareholding. Another one is what we call the share purchase agreement. What share purchase agreement means is that initially for the Ujesera Airport Company, we are partners with Motor Angel. I hope you know that, 75% Motor and 25% the government of Rwanda, ATL. Now, what we have to do in terms of that exercise was to purchase the 75% of the Motor shares so that we have 100% before we can engage another partner. So now, having done that, they had to buy the 60% from us. That's why you call it a share purchase agreement. I don't know if it is clear. So that they get 60% and we are 40%, and then we agree to go together as partners. The third one is basically the guarantee, because the ATL is the one that is committing as a shareholder. In case of any kind of default, in case of any other liabilities, then they are guaranteed by the government. So that indemnification agreement that is backed by government guarantee is also what has been signed. So those are the three agreements that we have signed. And these ones is now to build not the original airport that we wanted, a small airport, well, relatively, I would say not a small one because it is bigger than what we had. But this time, we are bringing it now to another level. In other words, the first phase will be able to be sufficient to cater for 7 million passengers. And the second phase will be 14 million passengers. Remember now we are about 1.3 million. Okay? So, but here the first phase will be 7 million. I think it's going to become a big airport. The size, you know, it is 2,400 hectares of land. So it will have enough space. But now we are building a first-class airport that is going to really an airport of the future, where now we can also be able to expand as we wish. But it's going to be built in a modern way. The broad plans, we are working with them. Once it becomes such an international airport, even all the other airlines, which have not been coming because of the nature of our airport, will be coming to Rwanda. And this becomes like a hub, as you rightly mentioned. Because we'll be having a first class this time airport that is not like the one that we are having. And then interlinking with the whole, all the continents will be much easier. And once you have such an airport, in the airport, there is what they call the duty free. I'm sure you see. If you go to Amsterdam, you find everybody is purchasing almost everything, from food, to clothing, to other things, all the different items. You'll find that the one in Amsterdam, a big percentage of what they purchase are from the Netherlands, yes. Because it owns the airport. It employs most of the people in the Netherlands, then it becomes another market. It becomes another export market because it's the people who are in transit, the people who are going wherever they are going, they are the ones to purchase. It's the same thing as exporting someone to another country. They pay in the foreign currency and they buy as much as you put there in the duty free. So you find that it becomes a big market for all our made in Rwanda products in that airport. Then number three, it promotes the tourism in the country. The bigger the airport, the more the planes, the more the tourism that comes in the country. So we also gain, become in foreign exchange. It also helps in terms of trade, because there'll be also cargo freighter. So with that one, then they'll be taking our goods to other destinations very fast, compared to the situation that we're in now. That's why we are looking for a bigger airport. So it has all the advantages you can think of.